Find the domain of the following rational functions. Determine if the excluded values represent where a vertical asymptote or a hole appear in the graph. So to define the domain for rational functions, we are concerned where the denominator takes the value 0. So if we consider this example, f of x is equal to x minus 7 over x plus 12, I see that the denominator is equal to 0 when x is equal to negative 12. So therefore, the domain of this function is all real numbers such that x is not equal to negative 12. Determine if the excluded values represent a vertical asymptote or a hole up here in the graph. If we were to substitute negative 12 in, we would get negative 19 over 0. So when that happens, that tells us we have a vertical asymptote. When you have a non-zero number over 0, that would tell us a vertical asymptote. All right, so when x equals 12, negative 12, excuse me, a vertical asymptote appears in the graph. G of x is x plus 8 over x squared plus 6x minus 16. Alright, so we would have, again, we want to see where the denominator takes the value 0. So we would have x squared plus 6x minus 16 is 0. So this is quadratic, and we can solve this either by factoring or the quadratic formula. In this simple case here, I'm going to use factoring. The polynomial factors as x plus 8 by x minus 2. So then x plus 8 equals 0, which means x is negative 8. X minus 2 equals 0, which means that x equals 2. So the domain would be all real numbers such that x is not equal to negative 8, or x is not equal to positive 2. Now, if x equals negative 8, we would end up with 0 over 0. If x is equal to 2, we would end up with 10 over 0. So this is the situation we saw before, the 10 over 0. All right, so when x equals 2, we have a vertical asymptote in the graph. However, in this situation, we have 0 over 0. When x equals 8, excuse me, negative 8, a hole appears in the graph. Okay, so be careful about those situations. If upon substitution we end up with a 0 over 0, that tells us we would have a hole in the graph. If we had any other number over 0, that tells us we would have a vertical asymptote in the graph. In exercise C, we're asked to determine the domain again, and whether we would have a vertical asymptote or a hole. All right, so in this case, we see two vertical asymptotes. We see one right here when x is negative 5, and I see another one here when x is 3. So therefore, the domain is all real numbers such that x is not equal to negative 5 or x is not equal to 3. And both of these are vertical asymptotes, as shown already in the graph.